you don't finish the run through the line, it don't count. You gotta empty the bucket here. We gotta make this count. Do we understand?
In 2020, Delbarton fielded one of the most talented and competitive teams in the program's history. But that was then, and this is now. And this 2021 Green Wave team are ready to leave their own mark as opening day approaches.
This year specifically, we've been trying not to focus on last year. Like, last year was a great year, whatever, but we're dropping it. New year, new us, new team, new guys. Like, we have our own, we want to bring our own attitude to a game, you know what I mean?
We've talked about as a team just forgetting last year. I mean, we had a great season, great seniors, but now it's a new team. We got to develop new leadership and get this going for ourselves, but last year was still a great start.
You'd think it would be difficult finding new leaders after graduating 26 seniors. That's not the case here at Delbarton, who have a deep crop of talent. The conversation starts at the defensive line. Senior Pat Coy recently committed to Stanford, and he's preparing to be one of the top defensive ends in the state. Senior Chuck Nato is a presence in the middle who holds 8 D1 offers. D1 prospect Matt Gemma started on the line last year as a sophomore. He and fellow junior Nigel McSween round out a talented unit.
Just like our coaches set the standard, we're trying to be the most physical, most conditioned, most hateful defense. You know, we want to come out and, you know, kick our opponent's butt every single day. So that's how we're moving.
Man, I can't wait. We got 41 kids on our defensive line. And it's going to be havoc in the middle of the field in the trenches. That's what we pride ourselves in doing every day. Come out here, compete against their offensive line, and we just smash heads, and it just gets us better every day.
Standout linebacker PJ Casale is coming off gold medal performances on the Greco-Roman and freestyle wrestling circuits over the summer. A JSZ all-zone linebacker from a year ago, he looks to complete a defense that grinds daily in practice.
I think this year we're really preaching, you know, like offense and defense. You know, we got to clash. We got to come out here, practice hard every day.
With Cole Freeman off to Northwestern, the starting quarterback job was up for grabs, and it looks like Robbie Russo could be in line to win it. If that's the case, he has some weapons to throw to. Nick Petrillo played well in a breakout season at tight end in 2020. He figures to be the top go-to target on the offense, which also features players like Dylan Hakes, Aiden Papatonis, and Nayshawn Hill as options at receiver and tailback.
I've known Rob for a really long time. I've played baseball, football with him before, so we have a chemistry as it is. We worked all offseason for it. We got guys together in the winter all year. Like, we really understood that the guys last year, especially Freeman and all them, they're great guys, like unbelievable quarterback, but we feel like we have the same weapons and the same opportunity to put up the same amount of points that we did last year every game.
Delbarton opens on the road at Pope John on September 4th, and then their home opener is on September 11th against St. Anthony's of New York. The real test is after that, with 5 consecutive tough games. Those are Bergen Catholic, Paramus Catholic, DePaul, Don Bosco, and Seton Hall Prep. The Green Wave have worked hard to stay on top, and they hope that hard work pays off in the end.
You know, Michael Irvin said something. He said that the practice field is a battleground, so we try to come out here and battle every day against our brothers. Iron sharpens irons, and we're going to get better every single day.
We don't want to have situations where teams are inching up back closing the game. We want to put them in third, fourth quarter early. We don't want to give them any chances to come back.
Yeah, I mean, we're looking to win a championship at the end of the day. I think it starts up front with our D-line, O-line. We're on them every day about making this the best team we can. And then we got strong rising juniors coming up, quarterback, some receivers. We should be a good team. We just got to develop.
Reporting from Morristown, I'm Jay Cook with JerseySportsZone.com.